Welcome, Garry, to our studio, thanks for coming to be interviewed. We'll try to make it as painful as possible and really dragging. So first thing I was just going to ask you a bit about is, tell me a bit about your musical background.
There's not a lot to tell, really. I started writing music in 2000, I'd say. And I had an illness, and I didn't think I was going to be able to work. So I thought, I have to get some way of getting money into the family. So I was sitting down one day, and I started playing my guitar, and a melody came through. So that turned into a song called Stroke, which is what I'd had a couple of strokes. So that was the start. That was the very first song that I ever wrote. It's a very, it's really dedicated to the neurological foundation of New Zealand. It's not a very sexy thing, but it is. It's dedicated to them. So that's how it all started for me. As a kid, you know, I used to play guitar and want to be Cliff Richard and you know, the Beatles and all of that. I always knew I could do it better than they did, of course. You know, so it's all that sort of stuff.
So who would your inspiration be if you had to sort of nail it down? There are a few.
Randy Newman. Randy Newman wrote he's got a CD out or a DVD or something out called Bad Love. And I heard this thing, and it was all about when things go wrong. And you could see he was trying to express himself and get his emotions out that way. And here was I, sitting at home, after, you know, partially paralyzed and things like that. And I thought, well, this is a good way. Music is a really good venue for getting things out. So that's what I started to do there.
Yeah, so it started off as a bit of an exercise and trying to make some extra income. And how many songs have you written now?
I think it's 23 at the last count.
Wow.
But Dennis is having trouble keeping up with the recording rate. but I'm writing. I write a song probably every 2 weeks, on average. Yeah.
So what's your style, would you say?
I write some blues. I quite enjoy blues. I always thought that blues was this free, you know, sort of a expression. But it's actually not. It's incredibly prescribed. And as an engineer, that fitted really well. I thought, oh, yes, I know where I'm going next and I can do things properly. So blues is really good. 12-bar blues is really, really good. I enjoy that. But in my blues songs, there's always a story for them. There is always a reason for every song. So the unemployment blues, for instance, that's in a place where I was working at the time. They decided to restructure. Cut out all the fat in the system, you know, it was all political bullshit. But at any rate, they decided that that's what they're going to do. And there were a lot of people that were put out of work, or some people were put out of work. And some of those people that were put out of work really, really suffered. And one lady died as a consequence of that. And so I thought, this is a bit more serious than just a bit of a giggle song. So that's what the unemployment blues really refers to, and it's really dedicated to her for that. The Rararuki Blues is a song about an area that where we go hunting, and it's about the King Country and how beautiful it is, and there's a girl from Paraone Street that's mentioned in that song, and people will no doubt see her later on. Yeah, so that's the blues. Then I like to do. I'm not sure what it is. It's sort of a crossover between jazz, I think, and country. Jazz and country, if that's possible. And they also tell songs. Spotty my dog. Well, we have a dog, Spot, and he's our boy, and he's a pit bull. And he's just the cutest thing there is. And wherever we go, he goes. And he goes hunting with us, and he sleeps with us, and he does everything, you know. Well, not everything. But, you know, he's part of the family. And I guess when our children had left home and Spot came along, he's the surrogate child, if you like. So Spotting My Dog is really country. And when I wrote that one, one of the guys that I was with at the time, he said, I can see the boys in their pickups, you know, down in Tennessee and places like that, really enjoying that sort of music. And I thought, well, that's good. You know, that's what it's for. It's not pretentious. It's nothing more than that.